New driving theory test. Practice test number 7.1. In which of these situations should you avoid overtaking? A. Approaching a dip in the road. B. In a one-way street. C. Just after a bend. D. On a 30 miles per hour road. Correct answer: A. Approaching a dip in the road. Explanation: as you begin to think about overtaking, ask yourself whether it's really necessary. If you can't see well ahead, stay back and wait for a safer place to pull out. 2. You're being followed by an ambulance showing flashing blue lights. What should you do? A. Accelerate hard to get away from it. B. Brake harshly and stop well out into the road. C. Maintain your speed and course. D. Pull over as soon as it's safe to do so. Correct answer: D. Pull over as soon as it's safe to do so. Explanation: pull over in a place where the ambulance can pass safely. Check that there are no bollards or obstructions in the road that will prevent it from passing. 3. What type of emergency vehicle is fitted with a green flashing beacon? A. Ambulance. B. Doctor's car. C. Fire engine. D. Road gritter. Correct answer: B. Doctor's car. Explanation: a green flashing beacon on a vehicle means the driver or passenger is a doctor on an emergency call. Give way to them if it's safe to do so. Be aware that the vehicle may be traveling quickly or may stop in a hurry. 4. What's badly affected if the tires are underinflated? A. Braking. B. Change in gear. C. Indicating. D. Parking. Correct answer: A. Braking. Explanation: your tires are your only contact with the road. To prevent problems with braking and steering, keep your tires free from defects. They must have sufficient tread depth and be correctly inflated. Correct tire pressures help reduce the risk of skidding and provide a safer and more comfortable drive or ride. 5. Which type of vehicle should you be ready to give way to as you approach this bridge? A. Bicycles. B. Buses. C. Cars. D. Motorcycles. Correct answer: B. Buses. Explanation: a double-deck bus or high-sided lorry will have to take a position in the center of the road to clear the bridge. There's normally a sign to show this. Look well ahead, past the bridge, and be ready to stop and give way to large oncoming vehicles. 6. Where would you see this sign? A. At playground areas. B. At the side of the road. C. In the window of a car taking children to school. D. On the rear of a school bus or coach. Correct answer: D. On the rear of a school bus or coach. Explanation: vehicles that are used to carry children to and from school will be traveling at busy times of the day. If you're following a vehicle with this sign, be prepared for it to make frequent stops. It might pick up or set down passengers in places other than normal bus stops. 7. Which vehicle might have to take a different course from normal at roundabouts? A. A state car. B. Long vehicle. C. Sports car. D. Van. Correct answer: B. Long vehicle. Explanation: a long vehicle may have to straddle lanes either on or approaching a roundabout so that the rear wheels don't hit the curb. If you're following a long vehicle, stay well back and give it plenty of room. 8. Traffic signs giving orders are generally which shape? Correct answer: D. Explanation: road signs in the shape of a circle give orders. Those with a red circle are mostly prohibitive. The stop sign is octagonal to give it greater prominence. Signs giving orders must always be obeyed. 9. What does this sign mean? A. Parking for buses only. B. Parking for trams only. C. Route for buses only. D. Route for trams only. Correct answer: D. Route for trams only. Explanation: avoid blocking tram routes. Trams are fixed on their route and can't maneuver around other vehicles or pedestrians. Modern trams travel quickly and are quiet, so you might not hear them approaching. 10. At traffic lights, what does it mean when the amber light shows on its own? A. Go if no pedestrians are crossing. B. Go if the way is clear. C. Prepare to go. D. Stop at the stop line. Correct answer. D. Stop at the stop line. Explanation. When the amber light is showing on its own, the red light will follow next. The amber light means stop. Unless you've already crossed the stop line or you're so close to it that stopping may cause a collision. 11. At this junction, there's a stop sign on a solid white line on the road surface. Why is there a stop sign here? A. It's a busy junction. B. Speed on the major road is de-restricted. C. There are hazard warning lines in the center of the road. D. Visibility along the major road is restricted. Correct answer. D. Visibility along the major road is restricted. Explanation. If your view at a road junction is restricted, you must stop. There may also be a stop sign. Don't emerge until you're sure no traffic is approaching. If you don't know, don't go. 12. At which type of crossing are cyclists allowed to ride across with pedestrians? A. Pelican. B. Puffin. C. Toucan. D. Zebra. Correct answer. C. Toucan. Explanation. A toucan crossing is designed to allow pedestrians and cyclists to cross at the same time. Look out for cyclists approaching the crossing at speed. 13. There are flashing amber lights under a school warning sign. What action should you take? A. Increase your speed to clear the area quickly. B. Keep up your speed and sound the horn. C. Reduce speed until you're clear of the area. D. Wait at the lights until they change to green. Correct answer. C. Reduce speed until you're clear of the area. Explanation. The flashing amber lights are switched on to warn you that children may be crossing near a school. Slow down and take extra curve, as you may have to stop. 14. You're planning a long journey. Do you need to plan rest stops? A. No, only fuel stops will be needed. B. No, you'll be less tired if you get there as soon as possible. C. Yes, regular stops help concentration. D. Yes, you should plan to stop every half an hour. Correct answer. C. Yes, regular stops help concentration. Explanation. Try to plan your journey so that you can take rest stops. It's recommended that you take a break of at least 15 minutes after every 2 hours of driving or riding. This should help to maintain your concentration. 15. You're on a motorway. What color are the reflective studs on the left of the carriageway? A. Amber. B. Green. C. Red. D. White. Correct answer. C. Red. Explanation. Red studs are placed between the edge of the carriageway and the hard shoulder. Where slip roads leave or join of the motorway, the studs are green. 16. You're on a two-lane dual carriageway. Why would you use the right-hand lane? A. For normal progress. B. To keep driving at a constant high speed. C. To overtake slower traffic. D. When staying at the minimum allowed speed. Correct answer. C. To overtake slower traffic. Explanation. Normally you should travel in the left-hand lane and only use the right-hand lane for overtaking or turning right. Move back into the left lane as soon as it's safe, but don't cut in across the path of the vehicle you've just passed. 17. When will your vehicle use more fuel? A. When its tires are new. B. When its tires are of different makes. C. When its tires are overinflated. D. When its tires are underinflated. Correct answer. D. When its tires are underinflated. Explanation. Check your tire pressures frequently, normally once a week. If they're lower than those recommended by the manufacturer, there will be more rolling resistance. The engine will have to work harder to overcome this, leading to increased fuel consumption. 18. What's the purpose of these road markings? A. To enable parents to pick up or drop off children safely. B. B. To enable teachers to have clear access to the school. C. To ensure children have a clear view from the crossing area. D. To ensure delivery vehicles have easy access to the school. Correct answer, C. To ensure children have a clear view from the crossing area. Explanation. These markings are found on the road outside schools. Don't stop or park on them, even to set down or pick up children. The markings are there to ensure that drivers, riders, children and other pedestrians have a clear view of the road in all directions. 19. Some two-way roads are divided into three lanes. Why are these particularly dangerous? A. Traffic can overtake on the left. B. Traffic can travel faster in poor weather conditions. C. Traffic in both directions can use the middle lane to overtake. D. Traffic uses the middle lane for emergencies only. Correct answer, C. Traffic in both directions can use the middle lane to overtake. Explanation, if you intend to overtake, you must consider that approaching traffic could be planning the same maneuver. When you've considered the situation and decided it's safe, indicate your intentions early. This will show the approaching traffic that you intend to pull out. 20. You see this amber traffic light ahead. Which light or lights will come on next? A. Green alone. B. Green and amber together. C. Red alone. D. Red and amber together. Correct answer. C. Red alone. Explanation. At junctions controlled by traffic lights, you must stop behind the white line until the lights change to green. A red light, an amber light, and red and amber lights showing together all mean stop. You may proceed when the light is green unless your exit road is blocked or pedestrians are crossing in front of you. If you're approaching traffic lights that are visible from a distance and the light has been green for some time, be ready to slow down and stop because the lights are likely to change. 21. What should you do when approaching traffic lights where red and amber are showing together? A. Pass the lights if the road is clear. B. Stop because the lights are changing to red. C. Take care because there's a fault with the lights. D. Wait for the green light. Correct answer. D. Wait for the green light. Explanation. Be aware that other traffic might still be clearing the junction as you approach. A green light means you may go on, but only if the way is clear. 22. On a motorway. What's an emergency refuge area used for? A. For a police patrol to park and watch traffic. B. For construction and road workers to store emergency equipment. C. If you think you'll be involved in a road rage incident. D. In cases of emergency or breakdown. Correct answer, D. In cases of emergency or breakdown. Explanation. Emergency refuge areas are built at the side of the hard shoulder. If you break down, try to get your vehicle into the refuge, where there's an emergency telephone. The phone connects directly to a control center. Remember to take care when rejoining the motorway, especially if the hard shoulder is being used as a running lane. 23. Traffic officers operate on motorways and some primary routes in England. What are they authorised to do? A. Issue fixed penalty notices. B. Repair broken down vehicles on the motorway. C. Stop and arrest drivers who break the law. D. Stop and direct anyone on a motorway. Correct answer. D. Stop and direct anyone on a motorway. Explanation. Traffic officers don't have enforcement powers but are able to stop and direct people on motorways in some A-class roads. They only operate in England and work in partnership with the police at incidents, providing a highly trained and visible service. They're recognised by an orange and yellow jacket and their vehicle has yellow and black markings. 24. What should you do if you see a large box fall from a lorry onto the motorway? A. Catch up with the lorry and try to get the driver's attention. B. Go to the next emergency telephone and report the hazard. C. Pull over to the hard shoulder, then remove the box. D. Stop close to the box until the police arrive. Correct answer. B. Go to the next emergency telephone and report the hazard. Explanation. Lorry drivers can be unaware of objects falling from their vehicles. If you see something fall onto a motorway, look to see if the driver pulls over. If they don't stop, don't attempt to retrieve the object yourself. Pull onto the hard shoulder near an emergency telephone and report the hazard. 25. You're approaching a red traffic light. What will the signal show next? A. Amber alone. B. Green alone. C. Green and amber. D. Red and amber. Correct answer. D. Red and amber. Explanation. If you know which light is going to show next, you can plan your approach accordingly. This can help prevent excessive braking or hesitation at the junction. 26. You arrive at the scene of a motorcycle crash. The rider is injured. When should their helmet be removed? A. Always straight away. B. Always, unless they're in shock. C. Only when it's essential. D. Only when the motorcyclist asks. Correct answer. C. Only when it's essential. Explanation. Don't remove a motorcyclist's helmet unless it's essential. Remember, they may be suffering from shock. Don't give them anything to eat or drink, but do reassure them confidently. 27. You arrive at the scene of a motorcycle crash. No other vehicle is involved. The rider is unconscious and lying in the middle of the road. What's the first thing you should do at the scene? A. Clear the road of debris. B. Give the rider reassurance. C. Move the rider out of the road. D. Warn other traffic. Correct answer. D. Warn other traffic. Explanation. The motorcyclist is in an extremely vulnerable position, exposed to further danger from traffic. Approaching vehicles need advance warning in order to slow down and safely take avoiding action or stop. Don't put yourself or anyone else at risk. Use the hazard warning lights on your vehicle to alert other road users to the danger. 28. You arrive at an incident. A pedestrian is bleeding heavily from a leg wound. The leg isn't broken and there's nothing in the wound. What should you do? A. Dab the wound to stop bleeding. B. Fetch them a warm drink. C. Keep both legs flat on the ground. D. Raise the leg to lessen bleeding. Correct answer. D. Raise the leg to lessen bleeding. Explanation. If there's nothing in the wound, applying a pad of clean cloth or bandage will help stem the bleeding. Raising the leg will also lessen the flow of blood. Don't tie anything tightly round the leg, as this will restrict circulation and could result in long-term injury. 29. You've just passed your test. How can you reduce your risk of being involved in a collision? A. By always staying close to the vehicle in front. B. By never going over 40 miles per hour. C. By staying in the left-hand lane on all roads. D. By taking further training. Correct answer. D. By taking further training. Explanation. New drivers and riders are often involved in a collision or incident early in their driving career. Due to a lack of experience, they may not react to hazards appropriately. Approved training courses are offered by driver and rider training schools for people who have passed their test but want extra training. 30. You're on a long motorway journey. What should you do if you start to feel sleepy? A. Drive faster to complete your journey sooner. B. Leave the motorway and stop in a safe place. C. Play some loud music. D. Stop on the hard shoulder for a rest. Correct answer. B. Leave the motorway and stop in a safe place. Explanation. If you feel sleepy, you should leave the motorway at a service area or the next exit and stop in a safe place to rest. A supply of fresh air can help to keep you alert before you reach the exit, but it isn't a substitute for stopping and resting. 31. What should you do if your anti-lock brakes ABS warning light stays on? A. Check that the handbrake is released. B. Check the brake fluid level. C. Check the footbrake free play. D. Have the brakes checked immediately. Correct answer. D. Have the brakes checked immediately. Explanation. Consult the vehicle handbook or a garage before driving the vehicle any further. Only drive to a garage if it's safe to do so. If you aren't sure, get expert help. 32. It's important to wear suitable shoes when you're driving. Why is this? A. To enable you to adjust your seat. B. To enable you to walk for assistance if you break down. C. To maintain control of the pedals. D. To prevent wear on the pedals. Correct answer, C. To maintain control of the pedals. Explanation, when you're going to drive, make sure that you're wearing suitable clothing. Comfortable shoes will ensure that you have proper control of the foot pedals. 33. What might you expect to happen in this situation? A. Traffic speed will increase. B. Traffic will move into the left-hand lane. C. Traffic will move into the right-hand lane. D. Traffic won't need to change position. Correct answer, B. Traffic will move into the left-hand lane. Explanation, be courteous and allow the traffic to merge into the left-hand lane. 34. You've stopped at a pelican crossing. A disabled person is crossing slowly in front of you when the lights change to green. What should you do? A. Drive in front of them. B. Edge forward slowly. C. Sound your horn. D. Wait for them to finish crossing. Correct answer. D. Wait for them to finish crossing. Explanation. At a pelican crossing, the green light means you may proceed as long as the crossing is clear. If someone hasn't finished crossing, be patient and wait for them, whether they're disabled or not. 35. You're driving in town. Ahead of you a bus is at a bus stop. Which of the following should you do? A. Continue at the same speed but sound your horn as a warning. B. Flash your lights to warn the driver of your presence. C. Pass the bus as quickly as you possibly can. D. Watch carefully for the sudden appearance of pedestrians. Correct answer, D. Watch carefully for the sudden appearance of pedestrians. Explanation. As you approach, look out for any signal the driver might make. If you pass the vehicle, watch out for pedestrians attempting to cross the road from behind a bus. They'll be hidden from view until the last moment. 36. How can drivers help the environment? A. By accelerating gently. B. By accelerating harshly. C. By driving faster. D. By using leaded fuel. Correct answer, A. By accelerating gently. Explanation, rapid acceleration and a heavy braking lead to increase fuel consumption. Wear on your vehicle. Having your vehicle serviced regularly will maintain its efficiency, produce cleaner emissions and reduce the risk of a breakdown. 37. You've stalled in the middle of a level crossing and can't restart the engine. The warning bells start to ring. What should you do? A. Carry on trying to restart the engine. B. Get out of the car and clear of the crossing. C. Push the vehicle clear of the crossing. D. Run down the track to warn the signal operator. Correct answer, B. Get out of the car and clear of the crossing. Explanation, try to stay calm, especially if you have passengers with you. If you can't restart your engine before the warning bells ring, leave the vehicle and get yourself and any passengers well clear of the crossing. 38. What should you do when moving off from behind a parked car? A. Check both interior and exterior mirrors. B. Give a signal after moving off. C. Look around after moving off. D. Use the exterior mirrors only. Correct answer, A. Check both interior and exterior mirrors. Explanation, before moving off, you should use both the interior and exterior mirrors to check that the road is clear. Look around to check the blind spots and, if necessary, give a signal to warn other road users of your intentions. 39. You're driving on an icy road. What distance from the car in front should you drive? A. 8 times the normal distance. B. 4 times the normal distance. C. 6 times the normal distance. D. 10 times the normal distance. Correct answer. D. 10 times the normal distance. Explanation. Don't travel in icy or snowy weather unless your journey is essential. Drive extremely carefully when roads are or may be icy. Stopping distances can be 10 times greater than on dry roads. 40. Daytime visibility is poor but not seriously reduced. Which lights should you switch on? A. Dipped headlights. B. Front fog lights. C. Headlights and fog lights. D. Rear fog lights. Correct answer. A. Dipped headlights. Explanation. Only use your fog lights when visibility is seriously reduced. Use dipped headlights in poor conditions because this helps other road users to see you without the risk of causing dazzle. 41. Why are vehicles fitted with rear fog lights? A. To make them more visible in thick fog. B. To make them more visible when driving at high speed. C. To show when they've broken down in a dangerous position. D. To warn drivers following closely to drop back. Correct answer. A. To make them more visible in thick fog. Explanation. Rear fog lights make it easier to spot a vehicle ahead in foggy conditions. Avoid the temptation to use other vehicles' lights as a guide, as they may give you a false sense of security. 42. When leaving your vehicle, where should you try to park? A. At or near a taxi rank. B. In a secure car park. C. On a bend. D. Opposite a traffic island. Correct answer. B. In a secure car park. Explanation. Whenever possible, leave your car in a secure car park. This will help deter thieves. 43. What can a loose filler cap on your diesel fuel tank cause? A. It can improve your vehicle's fuel consumption. B. It can increase the level of exhaust emissions. C. It can make the engine difficult to start. D. It can make the road slippery for other road users. Correct answer. D. It can make the road slippery for other road users. Explanation. Diesel fuel can spill out if your filler cap isn't secured properly. This is most likely to occur on bends, junctions and roundabouts, where it will make the road slippery, especially if it's wet. At the end of a dry spell of weather, the road surfaces may have a high level of diesel spillage that hasn't been washed away by rain. 44. How can you help to prevent your car radio being stolen? A. Install a security coded radio. B. Leave the radio turned on. C. Park in an unlit area. D. Park near a busy junction. Correct answer. A. Install a security coded radio. Explanation. A security coded radio can deter thieves, as it's likely to be of little use when removed from the vehicle. 45. Which of these will help you to keep your car secured? A. Advanced driver's scheme. B. Car maintenance class. C. Vehicle breakdown organization. D. Vehicle watch scheme. Correct answer. D. Vehicle watch scheme. Explanation. The vehicle watch scheme helps to reduce the risk of your car being stolen. By displaying high visibility vehicle watch stickers in your car, you're inviting the police to stop your vehicle if it's seen in use between midnight and 5 a.m. 46. When are anti-lock brakes ABS most effective? A. When you apply the handbrake to reduce the stopping distance. B. When you brake normally but grip the steering wheel tightly. C. When you brake promptly and firmly until you've stopped. D. When you keep pumping the foot brake to prevent skidding. Correct answer. C. When you brake promptly and firmly until you've stopped. Explanation. If you have ABS and need to stop in an emergency, keep your foot firmly on the brake pedal until the vehicle has stopped. When the ABS operates, you may hear a grating sound and feel vibration through the brake pedal. This is normal and you should maintain pressure on the brake pedal until the vehicle stops. 47. Your vehicle breaks down on the hard shoulder of a motorway. You need to use your mobile phone to call for help. What should you do? A. Check your location from the marker posts on the left. B. Open the bonnet to help the emergency services know you've broken down. C. Phone a friend and ask them to come and collect you. D. Stand at the rear of the vehicle while making the call. Correct answer. A. Check your location from the marker posts on the left. Explanation. You should use an emergency telephone when you break down on the motorway. Only use your mobile if this isn't possible. The emergency services need to know your exact location so they can reach you as quickly as possible. Look for a number on the nearest marker post beside the hard shoulder. Give this number when you call the emergency services. 48. To help keep your vehicle secure at night, where should you park? A. In a quiet road. B. In a well-lit area. C. Near a police station. D. On a red route. Correct answer. B. In a well-lit area. Explanation. Whenever possible, park in an area that will be well-lit at night. 49. The Pass Plus scheme has been created for new drivers. What's its main purpose? A. To allow you to carry passengers. B. To allow you to drive faster. C. To improve your basic skills. D. To let you drive on motorways. Correct answer. C. To improve your basic skills. Explanation. New drivers are far more vulnerable on the road and more likely to be involved in incidents. The Pass Plus scheme has been designed to improve new drivers' basic skills and help widen the driving experience. 50. You're parked at the side of the road. You'll be waiting some time for a passenger. What should you do? A. Apply the steering lock. B. Switch off the engine. C. Switch off the radio. D. Use your headlights. Correct answer. B. Switch off the engine. Explanation. If your vehicle is stationary and is likely to remain so for some time, switch off the engine. We should all try to reduce global warming and pollution.